So in today's discussion, we are going to discuss about same unit, that is the unit 3, ballistic protection. This particular lecture is on evaluation of ballistic clothing. Okay, already you have learned about the fibers, fabrics, and what are its parameters that influence the ballistic protection. So now we will see, after once your ballistic clothing is made, how to evaluate that clothing. How will you know that the ballistic, how will you know that the bulletproof clothing gives protect? How can it protect from the bullets? How will you find it out? So for that, there are some number of tests are available that has to be performed to evaluate the efficiency of ballistic clothing. Okay, so for that, there are four basic tests that should be done. There are actually many tests are available, but we will discuss briefly about four tests. These are important. The first and the foremost test is the dynamic impact test. Okay, dynamic impact test. And the second one is the ballistic or weapon test, which is the residual velocity test. And third is the V50 measurement. V stands for velocity. That we will see what is meant by 50. That we will see when we speak about this, when I speak about this V50 measurement. Then fourth is the back face signature. First, we will start the lecture with the dynamic impact test. See, this dynamic impact test has other name also, drop tower test. Okay, this can also be called as a drop tower test. So from the word itself, you can understand dynamic impact means the impact is not static, it is just a dynamic, which is in the impact is in the moving state, in a very fast state. So this particular test, if you see, it is evaluated to check the energy absorption capacity of the materials during the low velocity impact. Okay, not for the high velocity impact, for the low velocity impact. And there are some standards for this. For example, if you are using the fabric, if you want the fabric to evaluate, for that there is an ASTM standard, which is the American Society of Testing Materials. That is the standard for fabrics. The standard is D3763, and for composites or laminates, if you want to test, the standard is ASTM. It is not ATSM. I am sorry. It is ASTM. D7136. Okay. So how this testing is done? For this test, you see, you have an indenter and you have a sample. You mount the sample in a particular place, in a particular like this. You just there are some upper and lower jaws. You just keep the mount the sample in between the upper and lower jaw, and then what you do is this, you have this dead weight, and there is an impactor, so that here with a predetermined velocity, the force is applied on the specimen. Okay, at a predetermined velocity from a particular fixed height, some force is applied against the specimen, against the time and displacement, so that what is the how much velocity you give, that is also fixed, like 1 to 24 meter per second you give the impact velocity, so that once the force is applied on the specimen, how much strain has taken place, that is tested by using a strain gauge or piezo sensors. Some sensors are there which is attached with the indenter, so that the strain is recorded. Okay, normally like in tensile strength also, you see if you see the constant rate of extension, one side will be moving and other side may be attached to a strain gauge to measure how much is the force you have applied, strain has taken place. That like that, similar to that, here it is an impact where a weighted intenter with some particular weight, it is falling at a predetermined velocity from a fixed height with a particular force. Okay, so whatever strain that is taken place, that is recorded. Okay, it is a very simple instrument. If you see what is the principle of the instrument, it is based on the conservation of energy. That is how much energy is absorbed by the material. It is between the incident potential energy and the transmitted kinetic energy, the difference between both, that is the potential energy and the kinetic energy. So with that, this testing is done. Okay, it's a very simple basic test for low velocity impact, like for example, some pistol or any kind of a gun where there is a low velocity impact is there. For those kind of low velocity impact garments, this drop tower test or say dynamic impact test is done. Okay, there is another test which is called the ballistic or weapon test. This is measures the residual velocity. Okay, that is the leftover velocity. This is one of the most important tests to test the suitability of a soft body armor for real life application. Means in the real life application, you see the evaluation of the ballistic impact, it is not that easy. Okay, so here this particular weapon test, it simulates the real life kind of a situation where the sample is mounted on a frame with or without the backing material. Backing material is something which will be along with the this specimen, that is the sample, so that the bullet is fired over the specimen. Okay, so here this test, if you see, is something different. There is no kind of a impact, just like a striker that is falling or an indenter that is falling on a specimen. It is not like that. Here, this simulates the actual real life scenario where there are some screens kept in order to measure the velocity of impact. Okay, there are some screens, optical screens are there placed to measure the velocity of the bullet. That is, you will find out the time. Okay, that is the by using the chronographs, which are equipped with the optical screens. These are kept to measure the velocity of the bullet. So here, how does it work? I will show you a picture for better understanding. Here, there are two optical screens are placed at a certain distance, and bullet passes through them. So the time is recorded. So in you will find out the difference in the time of the two optical screens, so that the average velocity of the bullet is calculated. For example, if you see, this is the place where you keep the muzzle. Okay, so here the test sample is placed. Okay, and here there is a screen 1, screen 2, and here screen 3, screen 4. Okay, this is the test sample. So from here, you just fire a bullet. So that what will happen when the bullet is going at a very high velocity, it will cross these two screens and it will just hit the test samples. And it sometimes what will happen if the sample fails, that bullet may penetrate at the reverse side also. So there is some at a particular distance, these screens are placed, like screen 1, screen 2, screen 3, and screen 4, like that. At this particular distance, these screens are placed. So what you do is, these screens are you keep chronographs in this. These chronographs will actually find out the time. Okay, just like a stopwatch, it will find out the time at which at what velocity to measure the velocity of the bullet at distance, how much distance in a particular time. Okay, so here these optical screens are kept at a particular distance. If you observe from this place, it is 9.2 meters, and here to here it is 2 meter, and from here to here there is in between the sample 2 meters, and then another 2 meters. So like that, it is kept at a particular distance. So here you find out the difference in the time between the two optical screens, so that you can find out what is the velocity of the bullet. Okay, the average velocity of the bullet can be calculated. So this can be done only when you use an optical screen with a chronograph. So here, how to calculate this? There is a basic formula is there, which is the basic kinetic energy formula, which is the energy equal to half mv square. I think you may be knowing E is the energy energy absorbed. Here the energy, in a sense, which is the energy absorbed by the fabric, which is equal to half mv square. Mv square is the mass, okay, and v is the velocity. So here we are finding out the difference in the two velocities, that is the before the bullet strikes the specimen and after the bullet strikes the specimen. Before the bullet strike the specimen is called the pre-impact velocity. After the bullet has struck the specimen, that is called the post-impact velocity. Okay, how do you know this velocity? You know this velocity because of the presence of the chronograph, which is present in this optical screen, that will record the time so that you can find the velocity, that is the distance traveled by time taken, that you can find out. So that the pre and the post impact velocities of these bullets can be calculated. So how much energy is absorbed? That how will you know the energy is absorbed? How much energy is absorbed by the material? That you will come to know only if you know the difference between the pre velocity, that is the before before the bullet strikes the specimen, how much is the velocity, and after the bullet strikes the specimen, how much is the velocity. So the difference of this, both the kinetic energy gives the value of the residual velocity. Okay, so from this residual velocity you can find out how much is the energy absorbed by the material. Okay, the residual velocity equal to v1 square minus v2 square, that is the v1 square is the pre-impact velocity, v2 square is the post-impact velocity. So if you know the difference between them, you can calculate the how much is the energy absorbed per material, energy absorbed by the fabric or the composite panel. Okay, so it is one of the important test. The next is the V50 measurement. Okay, it is one of the popular type of a testing done for this ballistic clothing. Okay, so what is mean by this V50? From the word V50, you can understand V stands for the velocity. Okay, so here it can be defined as the projectile speed at which the probability of the armor perforation is 50%. It means that when the projectile is striking the fabric specimen, the projectile comes with a certain speed. The speed at which the probability of the perforation is 50%, that is called the V50. Okay, at the speed where the probability is 50%, perforation happened, because when the projectile hits the specimen, definitely there may be a perforation. So at what speed you get the 50% perforation? Okay, that is called the V50. Okay, so here this is also one of the important tests that gives the very practical and provide good idea on the performance of armor. Okay, so how will you know that at what speed the probability of armor perforation is 50%? It cannot be done only when you just take a gun or any kind of a rifle to just do one time. If you shoot a particular fabric or panel, you will not come to know about it. So for that, what you need to do is you need to keep a fabric specimen at a certain distance, and you have to keep firing the large number of bullets, okay, at different impact velocities. Okay, and then you need to plot a curve. Okay, for example, if you you need to plot a curve with different impact velocity. You will fire what is the probability of the perforation. Okay, so at a 60 impact velocity, what is the probability of the perforation? And what at 70 impact velocity, what is the probability of the perforation? And at 80 and 90 and 100, like that, different at different velocities, what is the probability of the perforation? Like that, you need to make a graph. Okay, the x-axis shows the impact velocity in meters per second, and y-axis shows the cumulative probability of penetration. Okay, cumulative in the sense after you hit in the initially, if you have strike the bullet with say 60 meters per second velocity, and next shot may if it is say at 80 meters per second. So what happens? The difference 20, the whatever value that you got for 60, that also will be added with the 20, so that with the, so that it, at the 80th impact velocity, you will get the value of both the 60 as well as 80. Okay, it is a cumulative probability of penetration. So that what will happen with the increase in the impact velocity? Definitely, the perforation is going to increase. Okay, like that you start striking the specimen with the bullets, so that you will get a penetration. Or sometimes what will happen? Penetrations will not happen also, because every fabric panel is not that effective actually to undergo penetration. Some fabric panel will deflect the bullet, or it may be resistant to bullets, it may protect. So in that case, perforations may happen or perforations may not happen also. Okay, so at what velocity, at around say 50, for example, the velocity keeps on increasing, say at V1, V2, V3, like that, up to V100. So at the velocity of say 50, what is the perforation has take place? That velocity you are going to find out. That is called the V50 measurement. Okay. So here you see this cross mark indicates the perforation, that is the penetration, the fired points in the fabric where the penetration has taken place. And here, these are the circles which you can see here. Here in these places, the penetration has not taken place. So here, what is V50? It is the projectile speed at which the armor penetration is 50% has taken place. Okay, so that you will come to know only when you fire a large number of shots with the increasing velocity. Okay, so that plot which I have showed you is called the probabilistic velocity response curve, which is called as the PVR curve. So with different velocities, what is the penetration? Okay, what is the probability of penetration? At the projectile speed at which the probability of penetration is 50%. Okay, 50% it has penetrated. So in that case, that is called the V50. Okay. So with the increase in the velocity, what will happen? The perforations may increase. The amount of penetration is going to increase when you increase the velocity. But whatever velocity, when the perforation is 50%, then that is the highest limit. That is called the V50 measurement. So that this gives an idea about how well the armor is performing against the ballistic impact. Okay, so this is a more practical and effective method, like the weapon, the previous test method, like which we have seen, that is the weapon velocity testing. Okay, so for this testing, you need to make a graph, and you have to do multiple shots. You have to do, then only you can generate this probabilistic velocity response curve. Then from that curve, you can find out what is the V50 value. Okay, so this is the one of the important tests. And the next test is called the back face signature. Okay, what is this back face signature? So this testing back face signature, it is an assessment of blunt trauma behind the impacted surface of the body armor. Okay, so see, whenever you develop a bulletproof clothing, you do not use the bulletproof clothing alone. You keep a backing. That is, there will be a backing material which will be touching the skin. Okay, so why you keep that backing material? Because when a bullet is striking at a high speed in the specimen, if there is no backing fabric, what will happen? It will lead to blunt trauma. Yesterday I have shown you the person. If a person is giving a punch to the human body, what will happen? We get injury in the person gets injured. Why? Even the person is wearing a very strong protective clothing, which is made up of a metal, still he may get this blunt trauma. Because if this happened because of the absence of the backing fabric. Okay, the backing fabric is mandatory. Otherwise, what will happen? It will create this kind of an impression. Okay, so that what will happen, the internal organs may get damaged. Even the person is protected from the striking of the bullet, still the trauma take place. Okay, an injury take place in the internal organs of the body, like liver or inside stomach, whatever parts are there, that may get injured. Okay, that is why this impression is shown. Okay, so this, why this happens, I have told you, this is due to the backing material which you are giving. That also is very important. So this particular back face signature is also one of the important tests to find out how much is the blunt trauma, whether the armor that you have developed that protect the person from the blunt trauma happening. Okay, see, when the bullet is striking the armor, what happens? Even if it does not penetrate, but what will happen? The bullet, when it strikes the specimen, as I have told you, if it is a good, it is a very effective ballistic protective clothing, means it should make the waves generate more and it should dissipate the waves. Okay, the transverse wave, whichever is generated, that should get dissipated. Okay, the transverse wave should get dissipated. But in that case, in some cases, for example, the waves do not dissipate. Just if a bullet is striking a particular portion in the body, and it is just a deflection, in the sense it will just hit a portion and it will just turn back, it is not absorbing the energy. So that what will happen? Even if the backing material is there, the person is going to face the blunt trauma. Okay. So for this, how to determine the test for this blunt trauma? For this, what you need to do is, whatever ballistic protective clothing that you have developed, that ballistic protective clothing, you are going to keep a backing material, especially made of a clay. Okay. The clay, as per the NIJ standard, which is the National Institute of Justice, it is a standard. They recommend a particular clay called Roma Plastilina. Okay, so here, this clay, Roma Plastilina, this simulate the human tissue. Okay, the hardness of the clay which is there, it simulates the human tissue. Okay, so this is placed along with the bulletproof clothing, and then bullets are fired. Okay, and then bullets are fired. So here, what we find out is, this back face signature, how do you obtain? How much is the maximum depth of deformation? Okay, when the bullet is impacting the particular specimen, what is the maximum depth of deformation that has taken place? Okay, though the bullet is non-perforating, bullet does not penetrate inside the body, but still it has deflected, and it did not allow to the energy to absorb throughout the fabric surface. In that case, what will happen? Blunt trauma will happen. Okay, so the maximum tolerance limit of how much depth is allowed is only 44 millimeter. That is the tolerance limit. Okay, so like this, you keep for example, this is the armor panel. Behind this, you keep a material like this, like a Roma plastilina clay. Okay, something like this. And then what you do is you just strike with the fire this with the gun, so that what will happen, the impact, whatever happens, that will be the non-perforating bullet will form some depth of deformation on this backing material. So how much depth has this backing material has taken? That depth is found, that limit is only up to 44 millimeter. Then only if the depth is more than that, and then it means that the armor is not effective to protect from the blunt trauma. Okay, so this is also one of the important tests. Okay, so these four tests are the basic, are the very important to know for the ballistic protection. Okay. So I will stop here for today. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. You have any doubts? Yes, any doubts?
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, could you just explain once again back face signature?
Back face signature, okay. See, back face signature, it is the assessment of blunt trauma. Okay. See, you have developed a ballistic clothing. Okay. This is like a ballistic clothing. Okay. So, in this ballistic clothing, what will happen if the ballistic clothing is not effective? See, you are just, how will you say that ballistic clothing is effective? One thing is that if the bullet is fired continuously on the specimen, if it does not allow the bullet to penetrate inside, you can say that that is effective. That is a normal kind of a test. But in some cases, what happens, bullet does not penetrate inside the garment. But what will happen is the inside the body, you can see, na, inside the body, some injury take place. Okay. Why this injury take place? It because the bullet strikes the bulletproof panel, but what happens, it does not absorb the energy throughout the surface. Okay. What will happen is, if the bullet does not absorb the energy, what will happen is it may deflect. It will just hit and the bullet may deflect. So in that case, the energy is not absorbed throughout the body. The energy will be at a particular place. So that creates this kind of a injury inside the body. Okay, so that is why we always keep a backing material. Bullet ke sa, bulletproof clothing ke saath iske piche, inside the, in between the skin and the body, you keep a, you in between the bulletproof clothing and the body, you keep a backing material. Okay, yes, your backing material is kept. Because whatever bullet shots are fired on the garment, the backing material protect you from the trauma. Okay. Trauma means it is an injury. In case your garment is not effective to spread the energy throughout the fabric layer, what will happen? The energy will be at a particular point. It will not, it is not dissipating throughout the fabric surface. What will happen? That particular place, though the bullet do not penetrate, what will happen? Still you will get the injury inside the body. Okay. How this injury take place? Because the energy has not spread out throughout the fabric surface. The energy is just accumulated in one particular area, though it has not penetrated. Okay. Though it has not penetrated, still it is only, see, this particular portion is not completely penetrated. It only, say, some particular inch it is penetrated. Still the person is safe. The bullet has not pierced inside the body, but still the inside part of the body got injured. Why it got injured? Because the particular place where it is impacted, that places in that particular place, the energy has not dissipated. The energy has just, the bullet got just deflected, so that there is no energy dissipation. So that creates a blunt trauma. Okay, in this place, the impact has taken place where the energy, because of the no energy dissipation has taken place, this has created the back face signature. Okay, that is the internal injury. Okay, if the bulletproof is effective, what will happen? If the bullet is striking the bulletproof clothing, it will generate this transverse wave. Through those waves, the energy will dissipate throughout the fabric surface. So in that case, it will not happen. Okay, but if the bulletproof clothing is not that effective, okay, it is not generating the wave propagation or energy is not dissipating, what will happen? Though it is not, bullet has not penetrated inside the panel to create, to make the person die, bullet still stops the perforation, but still the internal parts will damage. Why it damages? Because the energy has not dissipated. Okay, so that is why we always, you see, in the bulletproof clothing, there will always be the backing material. Backing material will actually take all the whatever impact is taking place on the bulletproof clothing. Immediately, the after the energy is absorbed by the fabric, that will also come to the backing material. Okay, backing material protect you from the blunt trauma. Okay, so here, how do you measure the blunt trauma? You actually make a fabric, whatever panel that you have developed, whether it is a composite panel or a woven fabric panel, in that panel you are going to use a clay material. Okay, clay material is made up of a particular clay called a Roma pastilina. It is a particular clay material. That clay material has the hardness similar to the human tissue. Okay, human tissue and this clay material have the same hardness, so that what happens, you will clip this clay material and over this you keep the ballistic panel. So you will just strike with the bullet. So behind this, after you have striked some 5-10 shots, if you take out that bullet, you can see it's, in some places impact will be very high and some places impact will be low. So that depth you are finding out, how much is the depth. Sometimes what will happen, if the impact is very high, it will create a depth like this. It is too high. Okay, it will create a severe injury. Though the bullet has not penetrated inside the body, still the internal parts has damaged. That is called the back face signature. Okay, so that is found by measuring the depth. How much is the depth of impression has taken place? How much is the depth of deformation impacted by the non-perforating bullet? The bullet has not perforated inside the body. It has just stopped. Some small perforation or it has deflected, but the internal parts get damaged. It is because of the back face signature, blunt trauma. Okay, did you understand now?
Yes, sir, understood.
Okay. So, any other doubt from others? Okay. So, we shall stop here for today, and we shall meet in the next lecture.